Financial Planner. I've got Dylan Malberg joining me this morning in our St. Louis Park studio. I'd like to start this week's show with a short story. A husband and a wife come into our office last Wednesday. Now, they'd saved a little bit better than $2.7 million for their retirement, and I can tell you that the husband felt awfully confident about their retirement planning and the direction that this meeting was going to go. But once we sat down and we started to dive into the conversation, we learned that nearly all 100% of that $2.7 million was in tax-deferred IRAs, 401ks, and this money had never been taxed. So this couple's done a good job saving for retirement. They've even allowed compounding returns to generate a healthy plan, but they overlooked some critical areas. See, they still have to pay tax on all of that $2.7 million when they start to withdraw money for their retirement. And because they had very little savings in other areas, money that's in savings or in tax-free Roth IRAs, well, they're going to have to withdraw a good chunk of money from these accounts each and every month, which is going to force them to pay through the nose when it comes to taxes. So we ran a quick analysis for them right there on the spot, and here's what we learned. When we considered how much money they needed to support their lifestyle, plus we started adding in the additional taxation on this money that they were going to be paying without any tax planning, and we were conservative. We didn't even make any adjustments for the looming tax increases. They're going to end up running out of money by the time they're 83 years old. Now, when we broke this news to this couple, they nearly fell out of their chairs. To make matters worse, if the government gets its way and increases federal taxes, if the state of Minnesota gets their way and starts to increase our taxes, the scenario gets even worse. Now, you don't want to find yourself in this position. So coming up in today's program, we're going to share exactly how you get taxed on 9 different types of retirement income, plus some defensive tax planning strategies that you should be taking advantage of today, plus how you can reduce, even possibly eliminate taxes altogether in your retirement.
Good morning, Joe.
Hello, Dylan. How are you?
Not too bad this morning. Say, again, you mentioned it. We're talking about 9 different ways or how 9 different types of income are going to be taxed in retirement. And you look at the news that's come out of Washington, D.C. here this last week with this first major tax increase since 1993.
And proposed tax increase.
And we were talking about it, and it's really hard to ignore it. So we want to make sure we have a lot of ground to get through this morning, but we want to make sure we run through it for the listeners of Secure Timer Radio.
Well, and we know that the Congress and the President, they proposed that they're only going to be raising taxes on those rich, right? They're only going to go after those that are making, as they've stated, $400,000 or more. But I'll tell you, this plan, when you start to dive into it, is going to probably impact each and every one of you, regardless of what your income's at. First of all, they're going to be going for corporate taxes. They're gunning for the corporations because these folks are, they're going to talk about 28%, raising it from 21%. It's going to make us the highest taxed country when it comes to corporate taxes. We're talking about getting rid of the so-called pass-through business taxes, the QBI, the qualified business income that so many small businesses, limited partnerships, this was all part of the tax act that Donald Trump passed. And of course, that's got to get eliminated. We're talking about raising income tax rates on individuals earning over $400,000, expanding the estate taxes. If you are a small business owner, you're a farmer, you're going to be paying, or the kids will be paying, I guess you won't be paying it. The kids are going to be paying higher estate taxes, reducing that. We're talking about getting rid of capital gains when you pass on, so there's no step up in basis. Higher capital gains rates while you're alive. We're talking about families that may have a higher a one-time event. It could push you above $1 million, paying through the nose there. And all of this was promised to us as Joe Biden was on the campaign trail. But now, because of the, they're targeting this last round of stimulus, they are now saying that they have to do this, and this is the next on their agenda. They passed another $1.9 trillion, $2 trillion of stimulus. We could argue whether or not it was necessary or not, but now, because of this, they are now saying they have to start raising taxes, and we're talking, you know, we've been talking, Dylan, here for how long about how the current tax code that was passed by Donald Trump was going to expire, was going to mature out here in December 31st of 2025, meaning January 1, we wake up on 2026 and be paying back to our old rates. But this is going past that. They're going even further along the way.
Well, and which brings us to, again, how the first way that different types of income get taxed, we're going to talk about this morning, is how these traditional IRAs and 401ks gets taxed. And you think about all your years you were working, you got the paycheck, and you got taxed at whatever your rates were, and you didn't necessarily have a lot of control over how much tax you were going to pay. We look at where we're at today and the amount of control you have to proactively pay tax today at potentially, well, not potentially, we've talked about it here just now, lower rates today than they will be in the future. And how do you start putting a plan around that with yourself, your current advisor, whoever you're working with for advice around this?
Well, and Dylan, because if you're only looking at the investment strategies with your advisor, I think you're missing maybe the biggest area of planning that we all have an opportunity to focus on right now. And that's how do we take advantage of today's tax rates. You know, when you've got your IRAs, think of this money as, if you got a, in this case, $2.7 million, as I go back to my story, that's not all their money. Sure, they could put it on their balance sheet when they sit down with the banker, but it's not really all theirs, because of that 2.7, some of this money, all of the money, it's never been taxed, is going to be taxed. Now, under the new proposal, we're talking about a first tax hike since 1993. We're talking about raising tax rates to almost 40%. It's 39.3. Plus, Minnesota's talking about raising their rates to up to 11%. We're talking about finally hitting over 50% taxation on this money. That $2.7 million, it could be a fraction of that, 1.3, 1.4. You know, when you think of your retirement planning, you have to start thinking, and now is the time to do this. You've got to start thinking about beyond just the investment strategies. Don't just focus on whether or not you should be buying a little bit more large cap or small cap. Should you be buying value or growth? Do you need international? Buy more bonds, get rid of bonds. All of these discussions we're having with our financial professionals is going to mean absolutely nothing unless we start looking at taxes and bringing that into our retirement plans. Because if you have an IRA, if you have a 401k, if you have a thrift savings plan, if you have a 403b, if you have a Minnesota deferred comp plan, if you've got any of these retirement accounts that you've never paid tax on, stop thinking of this as all your money. It's really a joint account. It's a joint account between you and Uncle Sam. And with the threat of taxes, higher taxes right around the corner now, you're going to be paying a whole lot more tax on these accounts than you might even know. And it can leave you with just a fraction of your savings. Now, I want you to take advantage of some very simple tax planning strategies today that can save you tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of dollars in taxes in your retirement. That's why we're going to make a special offer just to today's listeners on Secure Retirement Radio. You can discover how you can reduce, eliminate taxes on IRAs and 401ks with a free, customized, secured retirement tax analysis. It's the only place you can get it. Here's how it works. You give us some basic information, we'll gather this from you, and then we will bring it back to our lab, and we will determine some tax-saving strategies that are best suited and tailored for your specific situation. We'll then sit down with you, we'll share these strategies, and you can see exactly how much you can save with a customized secured retirement tax analysis. It's free, there's no obligation, but we're going to ask that you call us today. We work with families that have saved at least $500,000 to several million dollars, but for the purpose of this caller, this offer, I'm going to ask that you call right now and schedule your free analysis and see exactly how much you can be saving by calling 952-777-8838. Tax rates, they're going higher. The new administration is telling us that they are raising taxes. That's their new priority. They're past a $2 trillion stimulus. Now let's start raising taxes, and it's not just going to impact the rich. It's going to probably impact you. So we got a short window of opportunity here. Call right now. Talk to a team member. Find your schedule your complimentary secure retirement tax analysis by calling 952-777-8838. That's 952-777-8838.
Could you avoid paying taxes on your dividends and Social Security benefits in retirement? We'll explain when we come back.
At East Dillon Malberg, I'm Joe Lucy. More with Secure Retirement Radio in a few moments.
You've got questions about taxes, Social Security, income, and risk, and he's got the answers. You're listening to Joe Lucy on Secured Retirement Radio. What I want, you've got, it might be hard to handle,
but like a flame that burns a candle. Now, most of us Americans are simply in the process right now preparing and filing their taxes with their CPA. If you're not aware of that, they pushed it off till May 15th instead of our normal April 15th. And we've been doing this each and every year our entire working lives. But aside from a few deductions that might save you a couple bucks today, you're really just reporting history, things that have already occurred in the past. At this point, there's really not a whole lot you can do. You can maybe write an additional check to an IRA or Roth IRA, but for the most part, everything had to be done before December 31st, year end. Now, a few and smart, savvy individuals are going to take a road less traveled when it comes to their tax preparation as they're sitting down and doing this. They're going to take advantage of some defensive planning strategies that can save them a small fortune in retirement. The question you might want to ask yourself, is it going to be me? Welcome back to Secure Retirement Radio. I'm Joe Lucy, Certified Financial Planner. I got Dillon Malberg joining me in our St. Louis Park studio, and we are talking about how you get taxed on nine different sources of retirement income, nine different kinds of products, and how these get taxed. Coming up in this segment, the surprising truth behind how you get taxed around Social Security benefits and that dividend income you have.
Yeah, and the first two sources of income we talked about this morning was the traditional IRAs and 401ks. We just have to know that they're going to be taxed when the money comes out. And if you decide you want to continue to defer those as long as possible, age 72, we're going to have this required minimum distribution.
Age 72, you get to go on the government program. Mm-hmm. That's when they start telling you they got to start taking this money out and getting taxed.
No, we also have to acknowledge we have other options, other tax-free options like the Roth IRA or the Roth 401k, acknowledging that we don't have to pay tax on money of that in the future when we do take it out.
Once the money goes in, it continues to grow, can continue to grow compounded, no future tax on, and actually under today's tax law, no required minimum distribution. So that was another advantage of those tax-free options. It's not just Roth IRAs. We didn't talk about it, but life insurance retirement plans are another way you can look at it. Health savings accounts, that's the trifecta. You put the money in, you get a tax deduction. You take it out, it goes for medical expenses, tax-free. Tax-free options, you need to make sure you're looking at what those are and taking advantage of them before, as we talked in the last segment, we see tax rates going higher, which they certainly are going to start happening very soon. Dillon, what's the third type of product that we want to talk about, how they get taxed?
Yeah, we want to talk about how those dividends are going to be taxed in retirement. If we look at how they're taxed currently, there's two different kind of dividends. There's the qualified dividend and non-qualified dividend. And the qualified dividends right now get taxed at capital gains rate, which is a maximum tax rate as we sit right now at of 20%.
It's actually 23.8 if you throw in the extra income. Yep. Yeah, but most of us are paying 15%. In fact, many of us are not even being taxed whatsoever on our qualified dividends. But that might change.
Yeah, and we look at non-qualified dividends or taxed at ordinary income, and I guess that's kind of where we're getting up, kind of the heads up of this proposed first tax hike since 1993.
Coming out of our new presidential administration, the House and the Senate, we're talking about raising our qualified dividends, not just the non-qualified, but qualified dividends. We might see these actually double. They could go to 39.6% if you're a higher earner, means everybody's going to be paying more here. Doesn't just stop there. We're talking about eliminating some of the tax-free dividends and what have you. You really want to get your arms around this, because this is going to start impacting each and every one of us. If you're somebody that's built a portfolio about high-earning dividend-type investments, get ready. Here it comes, right?
Or you're somebody who worked for many years for a public company and you have a large portion of your portfolio inside just one company position. That's an area where you might want to start planning around that, because it's probably going to affect you more than maybe somebody else who has the majority of their money inside of an IRA or a 401k.
Really can kind of get yourself in a sticky situation. Do I pay a lot of capital gains on some of these companies that we've worked for, or whether we just made the investment along the way, paying us a nice dividend. Now the dividends are going higher. We pay, sell it off. We got to pay capital gains. Boy, it's a slippery slope here. And, it's not going to just impact those that are making $400,000. Anybody that's telling you it's only for $400,000, don't worry about it. You'll never get it. They used to tell us that when they started taxing Social Security, only impacted 3 or 4% of us. Now over half of us are paying tax, which actually brings us to that fourth investment we were talking about, Dylan, Social Security. How does that get taxed?
Well, we look at Social Security, and a lot of families end up shocked when they find out that their Social Security is being taxed. And in fact, they could, again, up to 85% of your Social Security benefits could be taxed. And really what it's dependent on is all these other sources of income that we've already talked about today, and what we're going to continue to talk about in this morning's program.
Well, you know, understand something here. If you are listening to us right now on Secure Retirement Radio, Social Security by itself is completely tax-free under today's tax code, and probably will remain that way. Social Security, if the only income you needed in retirement was Social Security, you would be able to get by with 100% tax-free. And when we do some optimization planning that we do in our office here, as we start sitting down how to maximize this mailbox income, money that hits the checkbook each and every month, oftentimes we're finding families that are looking at $60,000, $70,000, almost $80,000 a year that could be 100% tax-free. The problem is we have other sources of income. Maybe it's a little rental income, those dividends we were talking about, little interest, pensions. And maybe those required distributions, that money that's forced to come out of your account once you hit 72. Yeah, it used to be 70 and a half. They raised it on us back last December of 2019. And then in came coronavirus, and nobody's really been talking about it. You don't have a required distribution until 72. Guess what? If you were 70 and a half and you were supposed to take it by now, anybody that was there is now going to do it. But 72 is the new age, and you want to know how this impacts you, because if you're not careful, you will be paying tax on Social Security benefits. Up to 85% of that income becomes taxable. In fact, we oftentimes see families that are in a situation where an additional dollar out of the IRA actually is getting taxed twice, taxed on the money coming out of the retirement account, plus additional taxes on Social Security that otherwise would be tax-free. You got to start looking at how to do this. Part of the optimization strategies around Social Security is understanding that Social Security by itself, under today's tax code, and I foresee it in the future here as we go into the new tax code, which is sure to go through sometime in the next, 24 to 36 months. Social Security is still a very tax advantageous income stream. It doesn't worry about what's going on in the stock market, its mailbox income, but optimizing it is something that can definitely help you stretch out your money further in retirement.
Oh, and that's just why tax planning, not just this year tax planning, look forward tax planning, is so important to your plan, because really it's going to determine about how much you're going to pay Uncle Sam versus how much are you and your family going to keep in your pockets.
You know, Dylan, I was asked here the other day, you know, what makes Secured Retirement Radio, what do we do that's different? And the way I like to explain this is there's, when you're looking at your retirement advice, the counsel you're getting on how to help you make your money last throughout retirement, because most families want to maintain their lifestyle, they'd like to reduce taxes if they can, and grow their wealth as long as it doesn't compromise those first two areas. I like to explain to them that there's really three levels of basic service that you can get when you're looking for financial advice. The very first level is that basic level. It's the Robinhood account. It's the individual's Charles Schwab or Fidelity account, Vanguard accounts. You're buying and selling. You're making all the decisions. They don't give you any advice. The second level is where you start to get some investment advice. They're going to make recommendations. You should buy more of this, less of this. Let's swap out this mutual fund for that mutual fund. But it's really all about the investment strategies. they aren't bringing it to that next level that I think everybody getting ready for retirement really needs to start focus on. How do I take this money back? How do I create an income plan? How do I document that so I know where my money's going to come from? How do I pay less taxes? What are the strategies that we can be used today while we are at 40-year lows? How do I bring in healthcare planning, family planning, estate planning, things like this? It's where everything comes together, and most advisors aren't operating at this capacity. We're talking about today how you can be paying far more taxation on your Social Security. Up to 85% of those benefits can be taxed. But there are some very simple, straightforward strategies that can help you reduce or even eliminate these taxes altogether, so you get to keep more of that Social Security income where it belongs, right there in your pocket. Now, I'm going to offer here this morning a free customized secured retirement Social Security analysis. The analysis not only reveals strategies that can help you save a small fortune in taxes, but you're also going to discover exactly when and how to file your Social Security benefits to optimize those benefits for you and your family. It's a tailored approach that tells you the turn-by-turn directions on how to take your Social Security. The key to getting more for these spousal benefits if they're available to you, plus if you're eligible for other benefits that you may not even know still exist, we're going to make sure we share those with you as well. Now, if you're looking for a simple and easy way to get more income from Social Security, this is a turnkey solution and it's absolutely free. There's no cost, there's no obligation. The strategies we use are ideally suited for those families that have savings though. We're not talking about Social Security disability, we're talking about the benefits that you are eligible for at 62 to 70, 60 if you're widowed. If you have not filed for Social Security, give us a call right now and get your secured retirement Social Security analysis by calling 952-777-8838. If you're serious about getting more income from your benefits, don't wait. Call right now, 952-777-8838. That's 952-777-8838.
When we come back, how your different types of income like CDs, stocks, mutual funds could trigger a tidal wave of unnecessary taxes in retirement.
That's Dylan Malberg. I'm Joe Lucy. Don't go anywhere. More with Secure Retirement Radio. 9 ways that you get taxed in retirement.
He's a certified financial planner, fiduciary, and a contributor to the Wall Street Journal. And he's no ordinary Joe. You're listening to Joe Lucy on Secured Retirement Radio. You've got questions about taxes, Social Security, income, and risk, and he's got the answers. You're listening to Joe Lucy on Secured Retirement Radio.
All right, you got your IRAs, you got your 401ks, you got your 403bs, you got your TSPs, dividends, Social Security benefits. These all serve an important income source for you and your family to help pay for your retirement. But the real question is this. How are you going to get taxed on all these different kinds of income? And what can you do now? What can you do today? What can you do in 2021 that can potentially reduce, possibly even eliminate taxes altogether in retirement? Welcome back to Secure Retirement Radio. I'm Joe Lucy, certified financial planner. I got Dylan Malberg joining me in my St. Louis Park radio studio. And today we are talking about how you get taxed on 9 different sources. 9 different sources of retirement income. Coming up in this segment, how you get taxed on stocks and mutual funds, plus strategies that can help you reduce or eliminate taxes altogether. And let's talk about interest, Dylan.
Yeah, I mean, it might sound kind of odd to talk about this morning, but the number 5 income that we want to talk about this morning is how CD savings accounts, these money markets, how do they get taxed in retirement?
Well, you know, this was probably something we focused a lot more time on here a few years ago when we were still getting 4%, 5%, 6% on our CD rates of return. But now the returns are abysmal. I mean, if you're a retiree and you're trying to live off of your interest off your CDs, boy, that's a game where you're going to probably safely lose money. But the one thing to understand with this, if you've got savings set aside, if you've got money in the bank, and you're getting a little bit of interest, you're only taxed on that interest. So I got $100,000 in CDs. Let's say I'm getting a 1% return. That's $1,000 a year that hits the tax return. What does that mean for you? That means that there's $100,000 there that's principal, tax-free principal. I can use that early in retirement. Spending $20,000 out of my CD account doesn't generate more taxes like it would have coming out of an IRA. Yeah, I got that interest income. But understanding how this works, how you can bring this into a plan, It's about making sure you have a plan for taking your money back in retirement. And all too often we see families, in fact, this isn't just us, Bloomberg had an article that said only 25%, one out of four families even have a plan for how to take their money back in retirement. Looking at things like CD interest and bond interest is very important to understanding how all these different areas get taxed. What's the sixth type source of income we wanted to get to this morning, Dylan?
Yeah, we have to look at how the individual stocks and especially how these mutual funds are going to be taxed in retirement.
You know, I think most of us already know this. If you have a stock, if you buy 3M, Honeywell, Graco, you name the local company, or even if it's not a local company, your Yahoo, Amazon, you buy the stock at $10 a share, it grows to $20 a share. When you sell it, you've got $10,000 of capital gains. Now, capital gains can be, they're far more favorable than just taking money out of a IRA 401k, at least under today's tax code. That's going to be changing if the current administration has their way, which I think they probably will. But right now, if you're getting capital gains and you're below certain thresholds, single people are about 40,000, married couples under 80,000. I'm using some rounded numbers. Visit with your tax preparer to get the exact number for you. You know, that capital gains is tax-free. Nothing better than that. But even if you're in the next threshold, you're paying 15% tax, which is far less than the 22, 24%, 32%. Yeah, we get to higher incomes. We start paying 20%. There's a 3.8 surplus tax on this stuff that kind of comes in. Worst case, we're looking at 23.8% for most of us Americans. Dividends, capital gains, not only can be very tax efficient, but I also oftentimes, Dylan, we start talking about the loser's tax. When we start having an investment like a mutual fund where we lose control of the amount of tax we're going to be paying every year.
No, and you think about what a mutual fund is it's one of those, not saying that they're good or bad, but it's a package product that you're owning with a bunch of your neighbors, and there's times and some things that can happen in the market that can have some things that are out of your control that are going to influence your results inside of that fund.
Let's go back a year ago. About a year ago today, we hit the market lows, right? The market was down 37%. And I know that you, a more astute investor, you weren't the one that was calling the broker saying, get me out, but the neighbor was. Neighbor said, hey, I got that money in that mutual fund. Get me back my money because I want out. I don't like this thing. It's not going down. The market's going to go down forever. Coronavirus is going to take the markets to zero. So the neighbor calls and says, send me my check. Mutual fund company, guess what? After a certain period of time, they no longer can just spend cash they might have in reserve. They got to start selling investments. Problem is that after 12 years of an up stock market, a bull market, some of those investments had really high gains. So you bought into the fund, let's say, in 2020, 2019, but they've owned the Amazon, Netflix, Yahoo, some of these stocks that had gone bonkers, Facebook, at a very low rate. They had to sell some. You now got to participate in 100% of that growth. That's why I call mutual funds a loser's tax in many cases. Now, if it's in an IRA, 401k, nothing wrong, but I prefer to see investments where I can manage the taxes a little bit better. We're talking about exchange-traded funds. We're talking about individual stock selections. These, when my neighbors are blowing out, as long as I hold, I don't have to pay the tax that my neighbors forced the mutual fund manager, the portfolio manager, to sell out of.
Yeah, I know that we saw this was 2009, 2010, and that the financial crisis where you saw account values go down 50%, and then these account holders that own these mutual funds get this 1099 in the mail in first week of February saying they had this major gain that they have to now pay taxes on, even though their account values just got cut in half.
Well, I remember from 2000, 2001. Remember when the towers came down in New York? We had 9/11 and everything else was going on. I remember the phone call I got that next, it was probably about February. It wasn't right away in January. Client calls me up and says, what is this I got in the mail? I got a 1099 says that I owe capital gains of $10,000, I don't remember the exact number, it was something like that, on an investment that's down 30%, you got to be kidding me. How did this happen? Well, it happened because the mutual fund portfolio manager had to make some selections. They had to sell out of some investments because your neighbors were saying, give me my money. You did what you were supposed to do. You held on to it, and all of a sudden you get, we see it every year, right? John Bogle, Vanguard, tells us to buy the S&P 500 fund. Set it, forget it, And we have many of us are out there. We own this S&P 500 Vanguard stock for a long time. Each and every year, we start getting 1099s. Capital gains, we didn't sell it. Mutual fund manager had to sell something, made a change in the S&P 500 composition. We get to pay tax on that as we go, unlike some of the more advantageous ETFs or individual stocks. So if I asked you how much money you had in your retirement savings today, you probably can come up with a number pretty quick. You'll say, I got this much in my retirement accounts, I got this much in savings. But if I asked you how much money you would have to pay tax on that money in retirement, most of us don't have a clue. Remember, it's not how much you make. Nobody cares what your net worth is or how much you have saved. It's what you get to keep. It's what this money represents after taxes. And we want to offer you a very special offer today. Get the secured retirement tax analysis. Here's how it works. You give us a call. We gather some information. We bring it back to our labs. We put together a tailored, customized, specific approach based on your goals, your dreams, what you've shared with us. Then we will sit down, we'll crunch some numbers, and we're going to sit down with you again, and we're going to show you exactly how much money you can save with a proactive tax plan. Now, we're not talking about some simple deductions that might reduce your taxes by a couple thousand this year. We're talking about life-changing tax planning strategies that are very simple, can save you tens of thousands, sometimes hundreds of thousands of dollars. And the tailored analysis is absolutely free. There's no obligation, but you have to be a listener on today's program here at Secured Retirement Radio and call right now. The number is 952-777-8838. That's 952-777-8838. We're talking this morning about nine different ways that you get taxed in retirement and how some of this is going to change under the current administration's proposals to raise taxes. We have a short opportunity here to take advantage of some very simple, straightforward tax planning opportunities. I think 2021 may be the last year we get to take advantage of some of these. Numbers 952-777-8838.
Coming up next, the way you get taxed on pensions, annuities, savings bonds, and how it could put your retirement income at risk.
That there's Dylan Malberg. I'm Joe Lucy, certified financial planner. Don't go anywhere. More with Secure Retirement Radio in a few moments.
He's a certified financial planner, fiduciary, and a contributor to the Wall Street Journal. And he's no ordinary Joe. You're listening to Joe Lucy on Secured Retirement Radio. You've got questions about taxes, Social Security, income, and risk. He's got the answers. You're listening to Joe Lucy on Secured Retirement Radio.
Well, if I asked you how much money you had in your savings for retirement, you probably know that number right off the top of your head. But if I asked you how much you had to pay in taxes on that money, most of us don't have a clue. Now, remember, it's not how much you make in retirement. Nobody cares what the net worth is. It's how this money hits your tax return, how it hits the 1040 every year that's going to make the ultimate difference. And if all you're worried about is what the best investment is for us, sometimes we're going to miss that boat because we aren't paying attention to what could be the opportunity of a lifetime. 2021 may be the last year that we get to pay our taxes at the current tax rates. Now, I don't know. I don't know when they're changing this, but it could be very soon. Welcome back to Secured Retirement Radio. I'm Joe Lucy, certified financial planner. I got Dylan Malberg in my radio studio with me this morning, and we're talking about nine different kinds of types of retirement income, and more specifically, how they all get taxed. Now, in the final segment here, different ways you get taxed on your pensions and annuities and savings bonds. Plus, we'll share some more tax saving strategies that can help you save a bundle in your retirement.
Yeah, talking about the nine different types of income and how they get taxed in retirement. This morning on Secure Retirement Radio, we talked first about the traditional IRA, 401k retirement accounts. We have to acknowledge that when the money gets taken out, that they're going to be taxed at whatever the tax rate is going to be that year.
In fact, when you pass it on to the kiddos, they get to pay tax on your deferred savings as well, right?
Exactly. We have to acknowledge that Roth IRAs, 401ks, are going to be tax-free when you withdraw the money. Also, kids inherit them, spouse inherits it, all going to be tax-free to them as well.
And it's not just the money that goes in the Roth. It's the growth on that money, which is really because of the compounding. We look at our retirement savings and how much some of these accounts have grown to. Imagine if it was all tax-free, how much better you'd feel.
Talked about dividend income, how the proposed tax changes right now that are coming out of Washington are going to significantly change the way that dividend income is going to work. Social Security, let's make sure it's as tax-efficient as possible. Stocks, mutual funds, how do they work? We talked about the loser's tax along with the mutual funds that you might be owning. CDs, savings accounts, not a lot of income coming off them right now with interest rates, but whatever interest we are accruing in those accounts, we're going to pay tax as we go.
I do some quick numbers here, Dylan. That is six. We got three more to go. Number seven. Number seven is what, Dylan?
Number seven is how pensions get taxed in retirement. We're also going to group in here number eight, which is how do annuities get taxed in retirement?
Well, think of it this way. You know, the pension is really just an annuity, right? All annuities are pensions. All pensions are annuities. Some are deferred. Some are actually being distributed, you know. But if you have a pension, if you are fortunate enough, you're one of the 20%, whether it's a civil service retirement or federal employee retirement, or it's a cash balance plan that you had at 3M, whatever it is, if you have a pension, if you're one of those 20% that are fortunate enough to have a significant amount of pension, 100% of that's going to be taxed each and every year in most cases. Contrary to if I go and buy an annuity and take a distribution, how does that work a little bit different, Dylan?
Well, we look at it, we own an annuity that's in a brokerage account. You wrote a check for it or cash into it, whatever it might be. That we're going to look at just the gains are going to be taxed to us when we take them out. Where contrary to the pension, most like you said, Joe, 100% of it is going to be taxable to us every year.
And in most cases, it's kind of a proportionate thing. So if you're going to take a pension, an annuity, over 20 years, you funded it with 100, it grew to 200. Half of that money coming back is going to be taxable to you. The growth, if I take a withdrawal, is it always comes out first. But if I turn it into an income stream, like if I annuitize it, well, then half of that income would be taxable. Half of it's considered a return of principal until you get to a certain point that you go through the principal. But we can worry about that when you're 95. You know, most of the time, families, you know, there's always been a lot of negative connotation around annuities. And it's always kind of interesting when we sit down with somebody that is fortunate enough to have that pension to remind them that that pension is really an annuity. It's about ensuring the distribution of that income to an insurance company, passing on that risk and understanding how that works, how it gets taxed, what some of the tax advantages can be, what are some of the pitfalls. That's really what we've been talking about all morning here, Dylan, is we've been talking on Secure Retirement Radio about nine different sources of income, understanding how each of them get taxed. All too often, you know, we might be working with getting counsel about our retirement planning, but the counselor, the folks we're working with, tend to focus on where they get paid, which is the investments. I should be buying more of this mutual fund, selling off this mutual fund, buy this stock, sell that stock. You know, we here at Secure Retirement Radio think it has to go beyond just the investment strategies. A tax plan is different than an investment strategy. An income plan is different than a wealth accumulation strategy. Understanding the differences, if that's what you're looking for, if you're looking for somebody to give you advice on all of the different areas going beyond the investments, well, keep on listening here to Secure Retirement Radio because that's what we're all about. Nine different sources of income, Dylan. I think we are down to the last. We got the ninth here in just a second. And how all these get taxed? What is the ninth?
Oh, we have to look at the savings bonds and how they get taxed and whether you find them at the basement from when you got given it to you from your grandparents, your parents, whatever it might have been. Looking at how those are going to be taxed in retirement.
You know, we don't see as many families with savings bonds as we used to. But, you know, when I was in the service, when I was in the Marine Corps, they used to come by all the time saying, hey, you need to start setting aside money in savings bonds. So I bought a savings bonds back when I was, I don't know, 20-some years old. Well, 20-some years later, there's no more interest accruing on this thing. I cash it out. I didn't know that you had to pay tax on all that interest that had been accruing. Most people don't. You know, there's an option. You can pay the tax on your savings bonds as time goes on, but most of us don't do that. We let the money accrue. They then cash it out, and we get socked with all the interest, and sometimes half of the money is the interest, and you get hit with the whole thing. Now, if you have a savings bond today, just because it's taxable when you cash it out, you're probably getting a good rate of return. So I'm not necessarily recommending that, but understand how the savings bonds is going to be taxed when you take it out. Consider maybe using it for your children's education. That's one way you can get the money out without paying tax. If there's one takeaway from today's program, it's this. Keep in mind, nobody cares what the net worth you have going into retirement. It's how that net worth, how those investments hit the tax return that is going to determine how much money you get to keep. If you are going into retirement and all you've got is an investment strategy, you don't have a look forward tax plan. And if you want to take advantage of some defensive strategies today while taxes are on sale, 2021 could be the last year, I want you to take advantage of what we call the secured retirement look forward tax analysis. Now, it's just for the listeners on today's program, and it's a special offer because we want to share with you how you can dramatically reduce, even eliminate taxes altogether. Here's how it works. We gather some basic information from you, take it back to my lab. I'm going to tell you exactly how much you can save. You then have a customized plan on how to get more of your money back in retirement. Now, if you want to take advantage of this, schedule your secured retirement look forward tax analysis by calling 952-777-8838. That's 952-777-8838. We're only going to keep the phone lines open for another half an hour, so call right now, 952-777-8838. That's all we have for this week's program here at Secure Retirement Radio. Have a great rest of your weekend. It's great to see some sun again. And we'll be back next Saturday morning, same place, same channel, right here from Secure Retirement Radio.
He's a certified financial planner, fiduciary, and a contributor to the Wall Street Journal. And he's no ordinary Joe. You're listening to Joe Lucy on Secured Retirement Radio. You really got me now.